If you consider the two objects are collided to each other, after the collision, their velocities are different. So, this is the E1 and E2, this is the V1 and V2, the name of the object A and B, A and B, the masses of the object M1 and M2, after the collision, M1 and M2. So, my dear student, you check it. Okay. What is the conservation of linear momentum? The total momentum before collision is equal to the total momentum after collision if the external unbalanced force acts on the system, means absence of the external unbalanced force, that means in isolated system. Okay. So, you prove it, M1 U1 plus M2 U2 equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2, okay, with the help of the Newton's third law. How can you prove it? Suppose you consider the force acts on the B by the object A. Suppose you consider it FAB. Force on the object A by the object B, force BA. Okay. So, what will be its value? That means change in momentum by time. Change in momentum by time. Change in momentum by time. Del P A by T. Similar way, del P B by T. So, according to Newton's third law, you know it, F A B equal to minus of F B A. So, you put it here, change in momentum by the object A by time T equal to change in momentum. Okay, you can see at the bottom. I will try to write on this upper part. So, F of AB equal to minus of F of ABA. Okay? So, F of AB equal to del PA by T equal to minus del PB by T. Del PA means first object, object A, first object. M1 V1 minus M1 U1. Change in momentum of the object A, that means the first object, and change in momentum of the object B, that means M2 V2 minus M2 U2. Okay? That means M1 V1 minus M1 U1 equal to minus M2 V2 plus M2 U2. Okay? Okay? So, you see here M1 V1 plus M2 V2 equal to M1 U1 plus M2 U2. This is the conservation of linear momentum. Conservation of linear momentum. So, you know it, Newton's second law is the real law. You try to prove it from the Newton's second law to the first law, and you also prove it in Newton's second law to the third law. So, my dear student, actually the fundamental is the Newton's second law. You can easily go from Newton's second to first, and second to third. Am I clear? This is the conservation of momentum. Next, collision. Okay? Next is this, you know it, the lift. lift r equal to m into r plus sorry g minus a r equal to m into g plus a and r equal to m into g. That means when the lift moving downward direction with an acceleration a, when the lift moving upward direction with the acceleration a, when the lift just uniform velocity, no acceleration is there, that means r equal to mg. When uniform velocity, when the lift is detached from the support, that time the a equal to g. When it will move in downward direction, the reaction force will be zero. So for the lift, the equation is this. And next part is the friction. It is also not in your syllabus directly, no explanation. You only know the elementary idea for the friction. Friction, suppose you consider it, an object is placed on the surface of the table. Surface of the table. Okay. So surface of the table. So you see here, if the mass of this object is m, the weight of this object is mg. That is the weight. Okay. Due to this weight of this object on the surface of the table, a frictional force acts on the table. So a reaction force acts in the opposite direction on the table. The reaction force is equal to the weight of this object according to Newton's third law. And a frictional force acts on the surface of contact along the direction of motion, that is equal to F. Suppose F, a frictional force acts on the surface of the contact along the direction of the opposite to the direction of the motion. If you apply the force in this direction, the frictional force creates on that surface. Okay. So frictional force, that is the limiting frictional force. Not the words are frictional force, you consider the limiting frictional force is directly proportional to the reaction force. Limiting frictional force is directly proportional to the reaction force. So friction, what is the meaning of friction? What is the meaning of the friction? This object is just rest on the tab, on that surface. Why it will be rest on that surface? Because the weight of this object acts on that portion and the reaction force acts on this direction. And a frictional force acts on the surface of the contact of the two surfaces. Okay. So due to this frictional force, the object is at rest. Means all the forces acts on that point, the sum of all the forces will be zero, that time the object is rest. So the frictional force means it will not create by the person, it will not create by the object, it will create automatically on the surface of the contact. And if you try to move it, a force is created automatically opposite to the direction of motion, that means it opposed to motion of the object. That is called the frictional force. Okay. That is called the frictional force. That frictional force means it has a value, limiting value, so many terms are there. Suppose you consider it, the object is here. You apply the force on that direction. That force starts from the 0 and it will be gradually increases 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You see here, just 5 Newton force you apply on this object, the object cannot move it. And after this 6 Newton, you apply the force on this object, the object just started. Just started. 7 Newton apply the force, you see the object is motion. So this value is called the limiting frictional force. limiting frictional force. Limiting frictional force. This force, this limiting frictional force is directly proportional to its reaction force. So you avoid it the, you avoid the it the proportional sign, that is F equal to mu into R. So this mu is called the coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction mu equal to F by R. Coefficient of friction F equal to mu equal to F by R. So that value must be greater than 1, equal 1 or less than 1, that value must be less than 1. If the frictional force is more than that, then that the force will be always in this direction. So my dear student, you check it. So three types of friction you see in your books. One is the static friction, another is the kinetic friction, third one is the rolling friction. So static friction means object is at rest. Due to the resultant force will be zero, that time the object will be rest. That time we can say the frictional force acts always to the direction of it, opposite to the direction of its motion, first. Second is the limiting frictional force is directly proportional to its reaction force. Okay, reaction force. And last is, if the mass of this object is more, that time the frictional force also be the more. Okay. So, my dear student, friction, this force and that force, both are the vector quantity. So, the resultant force is this, direction is this, that is the S. The resultant force makes an angle with the reaction force. That is the angle of friction. This is the lambda. Angle of friction. You see here, you draw the parallelogram or the rectangle, the lambda, the value of the lambda, you check here, the tan lambda equal to, this is the lambda, height by base. So, height means this, F by R. So, you know it, F by R equal to mu, mu equal to F by R equal to tan lambda. Okay, F by R equal to tan lambda. If you rotate it on a fixed point, you see the value of the S will be rotated, and this is create a cone, that is the frictional cone. Okay, that is the frictional cone. And you see here the angle of repose. Suppose you consider it, object is just motion on the surface of inclined surface. Surface, you consider the inclined surface. Just you consider it, the inclined surface. Object is motion with an inclined surface. The angle of inclination, that means the repose, equal to, you consider here, the theta. Okay. So, object is here. So, weight of this object acts perpendicular on that surface. Okay. So, frictional force acts opposite to the direction of motion. This direction, it will be rest. So, if this angle is theta, you consider it, this is the reaction force. Because reaction force acts on the perpendicular on that surface. So if this angle equal to theta, that angle must be theta. If you consider it, this point is here. So this and that are 90 degree. This is 90 degrees. So that is the 90 minus theta. That angle will be theta. So this is the W cos theta. So W cos theta is the reaction force. Okay. W sin theta acts along this direction. That is the W sin theta. So the frictional force acts in the opposite direction of motion. Frictional force is acts opposite to the direction of motion. So my dear student, you see here F equal to W sin theta and R equal to W cos theta. R equal to W cos theta. R equal to W cos theta. What is the value of F by R? F by R equal to W sin theta by W cos theta equal to tan theta. So my dear student, you know it. Mu equal to F by R equal to tan lambda. Lambda means angle of friction. Lambda means angle of friction. That person, Anirban Banerjee, what is the meaning of it?
Recording.
No, recording. Here also one is the disturbing.
Disturbing?
Yeah. You check only. Okay. So, mu equal to F by R equal to tan lambda equal to tan of theta. Tan of theta. So, my dear student, you check here, this is the relation. So, from those relations, you can write this tan lambda equal to tan theta. Tan lambda equal to tan theta. So, lambda equal to theta. Lambda equal to theta. Angle of friction equal to the angle of repose. Angle of friction equal to angle of repose. So this is the question for 2 marks. But angle of friction is not equal to angle of repose always, all times, because you know it, when the object moves in a horizontal surface, that time the theta equal to 0, that time the lambda is not equal to 0. So when the object moving in an inclined surface, that time you can say the angle of friction equal to angle of repose. Except it, you cannot say it. Okay. So next part, suppose you consider it, connection lost. Akuni hole. না আমার তো এরকম আসেনি
দেখাইনি কিন্তু কিছু একটা প্রবলেম হচ্ছিল আমি ওরা শুনতে পাচ্ছিল না মানে ক্লাস যারা করছিল আমি বলে যাচ্ছি
কানেক্টিং বলছে
ওরা রেসপন্সই করছে মানে কোন পরে কি রেসপন্স করবে বুঝতে পারলাম না কিছু একটা গন্ডগোল হচ্ছে এটা
Hello, listen. My dear student, you will listen. Sound is clear. So, the angle of friction and angle of repose. Suppose you consider it, the object is motion on the inclined surface. What will be its acceleration? You find it. What will be its acceleration? You find it. Suppose you see here, this is the W and that is the theta. So, this is the W cos theta. And that is the r equal to w sin theta, and this part w cos theta and r equal to w sin theta, and that direction is f. So if the object is just in motion along the direction in downward, that time acceleration is created on it. Okay, so you know here that what will be its value when it will be rest. So when it will be motion, it will be motion w sin theta minus f, that is equal to m into a. Okay, w sin theta minus f equal to m into a. What is the meaning of it? Because you see here, this is the more than that. After this, the object will be moving in the downward direction, and the velocity will be gradually increased. The create some acceleration, that due to this acceleration, that time the force will be, resultant force will be m into a. So w means m into g sin theta, f means mu into r equal to m into a. So m into a equal to m into g into sin theta minus mu into m into g into cos theta. So a equal to g common, mm cancel, g common sin theta minus mu cos theta. So my dear student, you check it. What will be its acceleration? The acceleration is equal to g into sin theta minus mu cos theta. This is the value for the acceleration when the object is rolling on the surface of the inclined surface. So up to this portion, you see it, it will be clear. Any problem, you see again next day, and you only know this. Some questions are resonant question for the rolling friction, that means the kinetic friction. This type of questions are resonant question why we use the cycle or motorcycle and in the bearing we use the lubricant oil. Okay, and why the tire and your shoe grips to helps the person or the vehicle easily move from here to there. So many questions are there. You will try to complete it. Otherwise, I will try to help you for next day. Today, up to this portion. Thank you, my dear student.